definitely feeling the autumnal spirit right now. Not sure why, but I've started watching, I'm trying to watch 100 horror movies or horror movie adjacent things before Halloween. And so far I'm on, I think, 23. And I haven't missed a day yet. We have a bird lady, a bird person, and an owl person, and a bat person. You just like glue a bat or lash a bat to a headband. Same with a spider, basically, a spider person. Some webbing, some baby spiders, a big spider. Glue it on, there you have it. It's about to thunderstorm. I used to have a dog that would let me dress it up, but that was a long, long time ago. Oh, these are really pretty. These are like luminaries. I don't know if you've seen. I live kind of like near a Catholic neighborhood, I guess. And they do luminaries around Christmas time. Transform a walkway or lawn into a spooky scene with this makeshift graveyard. These stones are gray luminaries, paper bags, stenciled with epitaphs and trimmed into shape. Lights are placed inside them so the glow appears to emanate from the underworld. That is too cool. I love the way the paper bag luminaries look. Miss Martha, and I love the little like fairy tale theme, very cottagecore moment. The tool and everything, she's a fairy lady. Very cool, very cute. Oh my gosh. See, I've seen these magazines before, obviously. I've seen them several times, probably. Yes, I have. But I don't remember. I've been trying to hold off on watching it actually in my Halloween perusals, just because. Brie Bites the other day. You can see them on my Instagram, which is granny_witch, if anyone's interested. But I just made Brie Bites with mushrooms, and I bet these would be great. But the Brie Bites were great too. I just love cheese and mushrooms. This is cute, Red Riding Hood. I like that she's actually riding the bike. You've got a wolf here, a big bad wolf. This kind of makes me want to watch Into the Woods. Either the Meryl Streep or the stage play, stage production. Both are great in different ways, I think. Oh my, oh my god. A ravenous ogre. Get out of my swamp. Ogre could eat the whole pot of stew by himself, but the hefty batch is also a great way to feed a crowd at a party. A bone-in pork roast is cooked slowly in green coconut curry sauce until the meat falls off the bone. The sauce becomes even more vibrant with the addition of pureed spinach, tiny trees, broccoli spears, here. It's like something we've done before, or like there's cycles, and I feel like this year, 2020, there's a lot of like mossy stone kind of things, and it's kind of like this cottagecore-y type woodland fairy tale vibe. goodness, they're so cute. I love mice. I don't want them to be in traps, though. But the mice are cute. Oh, goodness. I just keep saying, oh, goodness. This is terrifying. Those are scary bees, but these are cute bees. And I love cheese. And honey. And bread. Oh, yeah. Love that. Love a live edge. Be so wood. Yes. To all this. I'm allergic to honey, but I know my limit. I know how much. recently, and I've watched Scream Queen, My Nightmare on Elm Street. I really loved that. And horror noir. It's like a documentary. Most of them are documentaries, but I really loved that as well. And it's like a horror anthology series, but it's like horror comedy, and it was so funny. I don't know what I was expecting, but you know, if you've watched your fair share of horror anthologies, you probably know that they're hit or miss a lot of the time, but it was wonderful. I loved it. It comes out on Blu-ray in October, and I'm really considering buying that one. There's some people that were on Drunk History, and one of the actresses from Greener Grass, which is a really good movie that's on Hulu right now. It's really weird, but it's really good. And what else? The House is October Built 2. I haven't watched the first one yet this year.